We've created cartoon gods that we force our children to worship, and yet we smirk at the simplistic hieroglyphics on Egyptian tomb walls. The simplicity of the hieroglyphic drawings, combined with the pictures and objects themselves portrayed as being holy, seems to amuse us. This anthropomorphism, god-making, is also performed by Disney with all their cartoon characters that we teach our children to worship as soon as they can blink. The Disney Corporation was started and funded by the FBI and J. Edgar Hoover as an FBI mind control experiment. Bohemian Grove, Moloch the Owl, was not the original statue or symbol of worship at Bohemian Grove. The original object of adoration was a statue of Buddha. From the 1880s until the 1920s, the Buddha occupied the attention of the Grovers. Buddhism originated in India with the birth of Gautama, 563 to 483 BCE. This made Gautama to be 80 years old. The number 80 symbolizes total control. These are photographs of the Buddha at Bohemian Grove. Buddha sat under a Bodhi tree. After 49 days of meditating, he gained enlightenment in the fifth lunar or moon month. This is exactly the same as the Christian story where, after 49 days, the disciples of Christ gained the Holy Spirit. Why do they call themselves royal and everyone else a commoner? Simply because they lay claim to the divine right of kings to rule. What divine right? What god told them they could rule over you and me? To this day, just as in ancient Egypt and Babylon, they must commit human sacrifice continually to generate the fear which generates the energy, which is the spiritual illusion called reality, that they need to maintain control within this hypnotic trance state. The human sacrifice rituals are supposedly performed in secret in the chalets of Bohemian Grove and the royal palaces of Europe and so on. As well, these human sacrifice rituals are performed en masse in the form of manipulated wars, disease and so on. This private club gets their sacrifice victims through the CIA and the MK Ultra Mind Control Program. MK stands for Mind Control. Many thousands of children are simply bred for sale to this program. Children are used for every possible perversion by the leaders of the world before they're richly sacrificed. The point to make here is that the very same hideous rituals take place all over. Southern California is also the area of the China Lake Naval Station, where thousands of human babies have been witnessed to be kept in cages for use as human sacrifice and future CIA sex slaves. This is reported by the CIA sex slaves who have been allowed unwittingly to escape to tell their story. The CIA slave story had to be leaked to legitimize the information regarding the Illuminati agenda that many people are now familiar with. All this information, and most of it accurate, is then a huge distraction, so the world misses the real plan, which is to massacre the population quickly, violently, and without mercy. Certainly, the royal elite politicians and Illuminati families are depopulating the world through war, disease and untold corruptions. Nothing, however, will compare to the unbelievable slaughter they have staked out in the next year or sooner. The blue bloods of Europe and the USA appear as normal and common, but they have a cold callousness about their demeanor. All the presidents of the United States are related and are cousins of varying degrees. The Roosevelts, Bushes, and Churchills are all related through King Edward Longshanks of England over 800 years ago. These are direct descendants of the conjured-up illusions of the Luciferian thinking group Egregore. These elite are often referred to as the serpent gods of old. The Bush-Clinton royal bloodline has been the puppet government running the White House or Orion's House and this agenda for 50 years. These puppets in turn take their orders from puppets higher up, as seen in Cheney and Kissinger, two elite members who obediently fulfill this elite cabal agenda and who never seem to go away. There would seem no point to switch the coach in the match game. Not only the presidents of the USA are all related, but the mafia families are also direct descendants of these bloodline families and close genetic relatives to the presidential families and the blue bloods of Europe. Deceit, hypocrisy, manipulation and the like are the family characteristics. Consider this. Why do we pay professional athletes millions of dollars a year to throw a ball or shoot a puck or kick a ball or drive a car? Why do we pay Hollywood actors millions of dollars a year to act, to lie, to entrance, to deceive? Why do we give millions of dollars to church leaders, televangelists, popes, Dalai Lamas, the royals of the world? We do this because they are the Kabbalistic rituals they, the elite cabal thinkers, need to maintain to perform their hypnotic manipulation, whereby they perpetuate total control. Keep this in mind when you take in your next baseball game, hockey game, tennis match, golf game, church service, or watch your next movie, or listen to your next recording, or play your next video game. They're attempting to manipulate you to become conditioned that they might use you at any specific time in the future as they gather you together in any of the before-mentioned religious events. The big bucks are paid to the top performers in their chosen ritual, thereby maintaining the quality of seduction to these religious events at a very high, irresistible level. The collective energy from these Kabbalistic rituals are then directed to any region of choice, depending on the next stage of the Illuminati agenda. Hollywood is the biggest controlled entity that's overlooked by the Jewish Illuminati. Everything is controlled, including all the actors, musicians, producers, directors. No movie script can get clearance until it goes past these Kabbalistic-inspired think tanks that add all the goodies to the movies, like propaganda, mind control techniques, and of course, subliminal programming. Music. Music is built on repetition. Repetition is the ideal tool for instilling and implanting subliminal hypnotic suggestion. Repetition coupled with a state of paranoia leads to an altered state of consciousness and an illusion-based reality. The golden mean is based on the Fibonacci number series, and therefore music is also based on the Fibonacci number series, as is light, shape and color. All music videos are completely sex-driven and filled with excitement and illusion. Again, all fine and dandy. A pleasure to see these cuties doing their thing. However, they take hundreds of millions of dollars out of our pockets, then turn around and give a few million back to a charity called Feed the Children. Just a moment here. Shouldn't that be the other way round? Shouldn't they keep a few million and give back hundreds of millions to the starving people of the world? Well, no. Not if you're planning on buying a $66 million chalet in Switzerland. Switzerland is the safe country for the Illuminati elite. All the stars love showing of symbolism. Most people are clueless what they represent. Of course, people don't. They start calling it the devil, a character that does not exist. Or Satan, a word they haven't the foggiest notion of what it means. Then disinformation spirals out of control through fear and arrogance and religious mumbo-jumbo. Religion. The whole Illuminati agenda is based primarily on the Jewish, Christian, Islamic religious dogma. Whenever you're in doubt about what they're thinking or what their next move might be, just read the Old Testament. or the New Testament, or the Quran. You'll find symbolic language that'll indicate how they think and what the next sacrificial ritual might be. The chosen people of Babylon became known as God's chosen people. And through a series of mythical maneuverings throughout these illusory ages, with countless conjured up God stories, the ultimate favored nation of the Lord became known as the Israelites. Remember though, it was only the rulers of the empire who laid claim to the divine right to rule. They in turn adopted a group called common Babylonians to manipulate via the sharing of Kabbalistic knowledge. Thus, the shaman or priest was anointed and religion was established. As the centuries slid by, Kabbalism was employed by many other groups. Eventually, it was passed into the hands of the Christian Roman Catholic Church and the Society of Jesuits. The Knights Templar, or the Christian Crusaders, also laid claim to this knowledge around 1000 AD. This same story, the Father God having sex with an earthly woman, immaculately of course, is repeated over and over throughout history. The Mary and Jesus story was about 1 out of 50 Christ Savior myths, and probably many more of lesser fame, all of whom were born on December the 25th. Most of them were crucified and resurrected on the third day. Check out Zeitgeist, the movie that goes through all this. Zeitgeist, a Zionist production, did not show the true meaning behind creation and the atom, therefore producing more thinking atheists and upsetting a lot of Christians all at the same time. Of course, they also made the illuminated cabal look like nothing more than silly sun worshippers. Their main goal is to destroy religion so to form a one world environmental religion, the worship of the environment. This will be achieved very soon, as we'll see later. This race of God's chosen people, the Jews, is emboldened through the Christian religion. The Christians, in turn, claim to be the chosen people by choosing to be the supporters of the chosen people. If this sounds convoluted, it's meant to be. Christianity is but an extension of the Old Testament of God's chosen people. The free world can now partake in the ignorance of accepting the Jesus myth. The Jewish-Christian connection then enjoined with the creation of Islam in the early 7th century AD. This brought together the three major players, collectively known as the Children of Abraham, or the Children of Human Sacrifice, who form approximately half of the world population. A soothsayer is one who divines or predicts future events. Jesus never lived or had an earthly ministry. Atheism. Yes, even atheists are religious zealots. Atheists will argue vehemently that science proves there is no God, which of course there isn't. However, they will continue to trust in the knowledge offered up through scientific research, which is based on the foundation of the electron, proton, and neutron, which is the trinity of the Godhead. How bizarre! This religion known as atheism, boasting the atom symbol, which is the all-seeing eye, as their logo. In the trance state of this three-dimensional plane, the deeper one is indoctrinated in the belief that science actually has some validity or reality. The greater is the disconnection with awareness and oneness. Even though I state there is no God, I am not an atheist, inasmuch as I do recognize infinite awareness and wisdom do exist. This awareness and wisdom is not spirit. Neither does it have any connection to learned knowledge. The worship of a creator, a supreme being who cares if I'm good or bad, and I better obey or go to hell. Sorry, I don't buy into that. The atom symbol is the oldest sex ritual symbol in the world. If you look carefully, you'll see the six-pointed star is formed by the intersecting lines of the electron's orbit. The six-pointed star is the star of God, the star of Lucifer, the star of David, the divider, the duality god, and is the star of Israel. King Solomon. Keep in mind that Sol-O-Mon is simply a name meaning sun and moon, and that wise King Solomon is simply a reference to the zodiac and the sacrifice made to the illusory Luciferian god. That sacrifice is the sacrifice of the sun and moon, which in turn is the son of man. Approximately 600 to 900 years ago, depending on the version of the story, a native North American Iroquois prophet from the Mohawk tribe named Hiawatha was credited with uniting the five Iroquois nations into one unified group to stand together against their common enemies. This is exactly the same unification principle used by Muhammad in the 7th century, where he brought about the union of the warring Arab tribes to create a single unified state. Unification through manipulation and deceit is a characteristic of Islamic dogma, which is simply one term to describe sun god worship dogma. This unification was used as a smokescreen to establish the Islamic religion, hiding who and what was really behind the rise of Islam. The Luciferian thinkers were the ones who were really behind the rise of Islam, working through the Judeo-Christian elite, passing on the mystery religion principles of the Kabbalah. The secret of secret societies. The secret of the apples, the poles, the duality, and the mystery or lie associated with a myth was supposed to be guarded by the lion and the dragon serpent. It was to be kept secreted away forever through the mysteries of religion and intellectualism, who are themselves the lion and the dragon serpent. They have failed miserably. We no longer buy into the lunacy of the thinking process, the subliminal trance-inducing process of religion and intellectualism, which is the Kabbalistic magic of hypnotic suggestion on a massive scale. People are starting to wake up, but at a trickle or snail pace. Let's clear the air on this shape-shifting reptilian garbage. The most primitive and ultimately dominant part of our brain is the reptilian brain. Me first, and everything else next. The most powerful and ruthless leaders on this planet think in reptilian terms, making David Icke's claim that we are ruled by reptilians a useful metaphor. The elite cabal empowered the reptilian brain through generations of interbreeding. That is why they have no empathy for some of their actions. Re is the prefix of the word reptile and is used in the normal form or reversed er frequently. This is to establish the message very subliminally that the reptilian-brained group entity is in control. There is no such thing as an actual, real reptilian race running the world, come here from another planet. There is only a reptilian brain cabal using the thought process, which has placed the whole of humanity into a deep and confused trance state. Of course, the purpose of having a smokescreen cover story, such as the reptilian race, is to draw attention from the real agenda, which is far more sinister, as we will see later on. The symbolism of the serpent and its association with ancient gods abounds many forms, including bears, fish, eagles, and so on. But the one which is of most interest is the serpent. Lizard forms depicted from time to time. This is in reference to the ancient stories passed down from generation to generation in regards to the serpent gods and serpent kings. It's these serpent entities that have been rendered down through history, that have been used as a front to instill the belief in a serpent race from other planets who run the world and who will ultimately seek to control it completely. In reality, of course, this is just a suggestion attached to the hypnotic trance state, and those who are deeply entranced by this suggestion seek to perpetuate the myth of a serpent race, not realizing for a moment that it's they themselves who are establishing the illusory reality that will include some form of serpent-minded or Luciferian thought process-based ruling elite. Anunnaki mythology. Interesting to note, Illuminated member who was born in Baku, Russia, and raised in pre-state Israel, interpreted these ancient writings, which is a language called cuneiform. Many other scholars now know how to read cuneiform, and there is a lot of discrepancies between them, especially time readings. Towards the end of Sitchin's life, he wanted to avoid the reptilian Anunnaki topic altogether, after admitting he could have possibly misinterpreted some of the writings.